En las instalaciones del Miami Heat en el FTX Arena nos acompaña nada menos que uno de los grandes francotiradores de la NBA, Duncan Robinson. La entrevista va a ser en inglés, ustedes van a captar ahora su respuesta y las preguntas también en español a través de subtítulos. First question for you. Put us in your shoes, particularly how defenses are now geared up to stop you personally. How does that feel? And is it getting any worse as the years go on?
First off, I understood part of that intro, I'd like to say. Second, I mean, yeah, you know, it's been throughout my career just adjusting and trying to be creative, find other ways to be effective and score. So it's nothing new, but, you know, it's a great opportunity to kind of be creative and find solutions to different challenges.
Following up on that answer, let's say that you're doing your job moving without the ball. You're being followed all over. Your teammate does a good job setting a screen for you. Now you were able to get rid of the guy who's following you, but they switch right away. Mm-hmm. What's your thought process? What do you do right away when you see that they're switching on you?
Yeah, I mean, if there's an overreaction and they have to switch out, then, you know, try to use that to our advantage, whether that's, you know, posting up a bigger guy who just set a screen against a smaller defender, or, you know, myself driving a bigger player. So just continuing to be, like, relentless in my pursuits. And, you know, if they get it right the first two, three times, whatever it is, hoping that they mess it up the third or fourth after that. So just continue to run my routes and be aggressive in that sense.
Duncan, players like you are kind of changing the NBA. Of course, Steph Curry's in the news lately. Ray Allen lives in Miami. I'm sure you've had chances to talk to him. I know that you're close with J.J. Redick. Do you talk to them? Do you try to trade notes? Do you sort of use them as sounding boards?
Yeah, for sure. You know, I think I would be silly not to. Any opportunity I get to pick those guys' brains and take whatever it is. And it might just be something small. I mean, everybody's kind of routine and preparation isn't going to be the same. But, you know, if I can take little things here and there and use it to my advantage, then that's a great opportunity.
But from what I know from people in your position, they're maniacal. They have a routine. They want things done a certain way. I can think of J.J. Redick. I can think of Ray Allen. Those two, for sure. I don't know Curry as well. How does it work for you? How precise are you in everything you do?
Yeah, I mean, I'm a very routine-oriented person, for sure. I always kind of have been. And when it comes to, you know, my basketball routine, it's, like, kind of sacred to me. And, you know, it's also, you know, one of the challenges has been, like, challenging myself to kind of be creative and mixing it up a little bit here and there. You know, the NBA season can be long. So obviously, you know, sticking to what I really truly believe separates me, but then also, like, finding little ways to kind of have fun with it and keep it fresh.
Now, on the maniacal, I have to ask you this. Are you maniacal about how you receive your passes? Does it have to be right under your chin? Do you tell your teammates, hey guys, I want it here? And who would be the best passer consistently that gets the ball to you in a position where you can score?
No, I'm not really super particular about that. As long as it gets to me, I'm happy to let it fly. You know, we have a bunch of great passes on this team. Kyle, Bam is an incredible passer for a big man. Jimmy's super unselfish, willing to pass. And then, you know, on down the line, Tyler, Gabe, all those guys. So they do a really good job of finding me in situations to be successful.
How about the other end of the court? What are the challenges on defense for you in the NBA?
Yeah, it's definitely been an adjustment, you know, the size and speed. Early on in my career, everything was just moving fast. And I think I've settled down a lot, kind of learned to play to my strengths. The same way I play to my strengths on offense, you know, I can play to my strengths on defense, you know, be really solid, be in the right spots, be a good team defender. You know, not miss rotations, all those sorts of things. So, you know, naturally, you know, I kind of found the teams will kind of go at me a little bit, which is a great opportunity for me to, like, kind of rise to the occasion as well. So, you know, it's been a growing experience on that end of the floor, but I feel like I've improved a lot.
I've been following you on your Instagram account, and you love your Asha noodles, of course.
For sure.
But you've been here for 4 years, and this is a very Latin community. What have you enjoyed of that segment of community here in South Florida?
Yeah, I mean, Miami is a super international city, and the different cultural influences are amazing. And it's one of my favorite parts about the city. Just for me, like, experiencing the different cuisines and going to the different places. You know, some of my favorite spots are, like, on Calle Ocho, or, like, some of the, like, the Asian fusion and Peruvian inspired restaurants. I mean, they're just some of my favorite spots around here. So that's one way I've really kind of tapped into this community.
And is Maine emptying? Everybody coming down to visit you because the weather's a little bit better here?
Yeah, I get a lot of visitors for sure. Yeah.
All right, well, listen, thank you very much. Best of luck. Keep shooting and making threes.
Yes, sir. Thank you, guys.